Frank's brought some awesome gun.
Frank, oh, new guns? More guns?
I thought you said 4:30.
It is.
It
close.
Is.
We're a little early, maybe.
We don't just like, we don't like start not right at 4:30. We gotta come in here. We gotta set up all the stuff.
God, just hang out for a minute. Frank dropping off the goodies as he usually does. I have a Santa hat one of these days.
Okay, so.
Woo! Is that the IAR?
You're gonna have to find a flashlight that can closely simulate whatever was in that picture because we didn't get our order.
Correct. Okay.
And our.
Are we painting that one?
Thing.
No? No one that either?
That one, that never came in either.
Oh my gosh, dude.
Are we gonna show that tonight?
We can't show this tonight.
We gotta paint it.
Yeah, we gotta paint it.
It's not done.
So, what I need you to do is find that a flashlight that we can simulate that with.
Okay. I'll find something that looks similar. Also, isn't he
sure?
I thought he was running a shorty.
The warehouse is so noisy.
Wasn't he running a shorty hollow?
Huh?
Wasn't he running a shorty hollow?
No, it's not the wrong one.
Oh, okay.
And then once you find that flashlight, Jason already knows about it. He's going to do the painting.
Cool. Awesome. Okay. Yeah, I will. Not yet on that. So I'll get with him on that and get that all taken care of.
This is the little tanker that we just do a stock on.
A little tanker?
You know what a tank gun is, right?
I'm unfamiliar
with those.
Inform me.
It's originally it's the Colt Car 15.
Okay.
But the stock is like that weird looking wire stock deal.
Yes.
So the HK made a 416 version of it.
Cool.
But I thought it was like horribly ugly.
Yeah.
So we pulled that stock on and
One
of these.
Cool. Warning. This is a crazy looking buffer tube.
I'll let you know what position you're in.
I like that. It's nice.
It's cool. So
small little 416C.
Yeah, but think about it. This section was shorter than the regular 416.
Right.
This thing is uneven.
416 compacts. It's pretty legit. I totally like this gun.
The front sight really doesn't.
I want to chit chat with our.
Front sight really bothers me.
Yeah. The front sight? How it lays down like that?
Yeah
I pulled it off, but
it looks funny with it off.
Yeah, well, because it's all scratched up right here from it moving up and down.
Right, because it has that weird
paint
one.
Got scratched off, so we just decided to leave it.
That just looks awkward.
I agree. The sights on this front sight's a little.
Hey, this is cool.
Yeah, I know. That's what I was saying. It's like a pretty cool looking stock. What we're talking about is the. I don't know if you guys can see that. There's like a
numbers.
Football marking, or not football marking. It's
tell
like
what position you're in.
Yeah. Tells you what position you're in.
Yeah,
the missionary?
Because if you didn't know already.
Yeah. Some people care, you know.
If you have to know what position you're in, you might be doing it wrong.
Yeah. You know, if someone's just like, my gun is just, it's not comfortable. Well, you should try position 5 instead of the 2 you have it on.
Have you tried 3? I really like it. I think 5's going to be where I'm at.
This is cool. Suggesting a Magpul MOE grip on this thing?
MOE grip. I think this comes with it. Isn't this a signature grip from this?
416 grip.
Yeah, 416 grip, yeah. I recently saw the
those
Magpul DMRs you brought in. The grip on those actually has a little Magpul logo.
Yeah.
Is the stipling. I was like, wow, that's kind of great.
So
we'll
start doing that after a while.
Yeah, it's neat.
You can do that?
What?
How what would Magpul you need to do that?
Magpul stipling?
Yeah, you would need like a Magpul laser stamp?
Yeah, pretty much. I would assume.
It was just cut into their molds.
Yeah, I know.
Mold and there's little.
That's badass.
Symbols.
It is pretty sweet. If you guys don't know what we're talking about, the grip on some of the new. I'm not sure if it's like the newer Magpul stuff. MOE grips. Yeah, the stipling or whatever you want to call it, the texture. Basically replicates the little Magpul symbol, so it's like really tiny little Magpul symbols all over the place. So.
Is it me? Or is anybody moderating this out front?
We have Airsoft GI. What looks like Aaron and. No, Aaron.
Mark.
And Andrew is what I meant to say.
Josh, that's you. You're here.
Oh, I'm moderating from here, guys.
Okay.
Cool. Crazy. Doing it big.
DWT. What's up, man? We're just chatting on Facebook.
You're never the, today you're not the off.
I know. I'm usually the voice in the background, kind of moderating things. Like, hey, guys, get back on subject.
Here, let me my belly into the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Raging Hippo.
This is the Raging Hippo.
This is the Raging Hippo. Welcome to live stream, guys. We are now officially 2 minutes away from real broadcast. This is just the pre-show where we're kind of, you know, laughing about things, having a good time.
New Josh guns. Is the one. Is Wink KWACQR? Are you talking about the new intro with all the sponsors and stuff? Because that actually
That actually Ross. Wasn't Josh.
Yeah, that was Ross who made
We have a new Predator. We're all about second chances here at Airsoft GI.
Predator
so
2.
We've got Predator, Predator number 2.
Predator 2. We're making sequels,
Ross.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Pretty soon.
Ross made that intro, so we'll pass along your praises, I guess.
AVP soon, right?
AVP? Yeah, Aliens versus Predator. Predator. Different Predator.
Is it possible to get an autograph? I think I got your email. I was going to say, I'm trying to see if I can wrangle up one of the promo shirts. I think I have one at my house. And then we can, you know, all sign it and send it off to you. So, Grom, if you want to send me your address and email, it's Josh, the letter E, at airsoftgi.com.
Is it possible to get an autograph?
I'll hook it
it's
up.
Possible.
You know, it's possible for sure.
Anything's
we had somebody,
possible.
We had somebody ask for a request to do a gingerbread man fighting a dragon on a hillside, which was very accurate.
No. He asked for a gingerbread man on a rainbow fighting a dragon.
Yeah, on the box, which was definitely facilitated. After I saw the picture, I was like, not the gumdrop buttons! So, that's a Shrek reference.
Yeah, somebody just asked him, you know, we have order comments when you make orders with us, and so some people put ridiculous things in the comments, and sometimes we respond ridiculously.
Yeah, exactly. So, hey man, you want a rainbow? You want a gingerbread man on a rainbow fighting a dragon?
KWA versus G&P. You guys want to know what our opinion is on that?
I haven't used anything from G&P ever.
I have. G&P is one of the older airsoft companies.
I know
are you talking about
war,
gas
right?
blowbacks or AEGs internally? Internally.
Yeah, I can't speak on this.
KW.
Frank is here. He votes for KWA. I'm going to have to side with Frank on this. I think that KWA probably makes
I own an SR7.
A lot of people like G&P, though.
I know the G&P, they make good stuff, right? But I think that my first impression of G&P was when they had that gearbox molding problem back in the day. So that was my first impression of G&P. For those of you that don't know, G&P had a gearbox mold issue a long time ago, like 5 years ago almost.
Yeah.
Their gearbox molding was terrible, and so it just kept breaking and breaking and breaking.
Telephone.
And so that was my first impression of G&P, so I don't really like it that much. Yo.
How does the spring system work on this?
We're live. We're doing it live.
Is there a reason that
right now?
You turn this dial and it should move up and down.
Yeah.
How does it move?
You're live.
No, that moves itself.
Don't worry. Nobody knows who
right.
you are.
So
I'm going to watch Zero Dark 30 after work.
I don't know. I actually haven't really checked this out. I just took it
at the Arclight in Hollywood.
Zero Dark 30, guys. I'm excited. We get to go see some really
I'll catch
cool
you later.
Movie. I haven't seen anything about it too much yet, but we're going to find out about it. So.
Zero Dark 30.
I have no idea what that's about. Zero Dark 30.
What movie are we watching?
We are watching a movie. I have a strong feeling it's going to be like 14 minutes of action footage where they're going in and actually taking care of the perpetrator known as Osama bin Laden.
Yeah, the only thing I can think of is this is all it does.
Okay, so no real purpose
I
for
really
that.
I really don't know.
Yeah, it is kind of a strange feature. But we're going to go see that at the
Arclight
in Hollywood, which is a pretty legit movie theater from what I hear, so I'm excited
for
that.
Have you ever been to Arclight in Hollywood?
I have not actually been to the Arclight.
There's an Arclight in Pasadena. Have you been there?
Is that the one where they have, like,
Colorado.
the
Yes.
Okay.
Director's chairs?
Yeah. Then yes, I have seen such place. I think when I went there, I may have not remembered my trip entirely. It may have been after a profuse night of food and drink and fine-spirited beverages with my amigos, so... So,
aren't they only releasing it in New York City and LA? I don't know. See, this is what's
going
on.
Well, we live in LA, so.
This is true. Zero Dark 30 comes out in January, but they're doing special engagements in select theaters.
Correct.
And so we're going to see it in a select theater tonight.
Right.
Yes.
Which is exciting.
Link, get rid of that guy.
That actually won't do anything because the links are disabled, so he had to type that out. So it doesn't actually click anywhere.
I still want to kick him anyway.
Yeah,
can I do that?
Raisby, scroll down on the list.
Where's that?
Up. R, down.
Oh, that's too much work for
you. See, this is why I'm good at my job. Someone posts a link, boop, banhammer. So.
Yeah, the banhammer, I like that.
Yeah.
Hi, Tim. Hi, Josh.
Why do I see my name with a question mark there?
Because someone was asking if you were still here, which he is. He's right there off camera. You guys cannot see him, so.
Tim has nice hair today. Thank you.
I know, I think it's going for that.
It's undone.
Oh, what was that movie with Nicolas Cage where he looks like an idiot? Oh, wait, all of them. So
what?
Except for Gone in 60 Seconds.
Face Off, where he looked like John Travolta.
For Gone, he was John Travolta.
He was John Travolta.
Twist of plot.
Somebody wants to ask me a question.
Ask a question, then we will probably try to read it. Do a Frank tackle your heads. Does Frank play on a regular basis? Do you, Frank?
Frank plays on a regular basis.
Frank plays private games.
Yeah.
Frank plays on a regular basis whenever Frank decides to play.
Yeah. Frank decides to play when he decides to play. And Frank plays private games where people don't bitch about FPS or Rate of Fire, so...
This is a true story where the rules are all made up and the points don't matter.
Yeah, what is it? I think it's backwards. Where everything is made up and the points don't matter.
What's your primary weapon? I run a Bravo PDW.
What day of the week is it? That should be your answer.
Currently a Thursday. Yeah, exactly. A Bravo PDW, is what you said?
Yes, I do.
Bravo PDW. And then what's the rate of fire on that?
Nothing too crazy.
Just kind of something reliable that good old Facebook gets to go.
Nothing crazy. 35.
Nothing crazy.
25.
Oh, you said 25. I thought you said 25.
Well, 25 is reasonable. We'll give you that.
Nothing crazy. Man. Just 35 BBs.
Well, see, here's the thing. If I work on guns all day,
you
don't want guns.
When I go play, I don't want to work on guns.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we went and played pretty recently over at Hollywood Sports Park, and Mark has a pretty high speed gun. And there was one part where I was kind of just being real low profile on this door. I was going to pop out and get him, and he just had to jump on me, and I just was like, oh, pain everywhere really fast.
See, so Frank is lazy, so he likes to sneak up behind people and shoot him from the back.
Real slow.
Dude, Mark's gun is crazy, though.
Pretty good, yeah.
Numerous occasions where I just barely saw him, and I get one shot off, and I get lit up in the face by like 10 BBs.
Mark's guns are pretty legit, so I do enjoy them.
I'm taking the footage that we got yesterday. I'm just basically going to take my headcam footage, cut out most of the boring parts, and then just upload it as just raw action
footage. I'm telling you,
dude,
do a commentary over it, man. People would love to see that. So I would love to see a commentary.
The commentary would be kind of cool.
There were some pretty cool
parts.
Maybe I can do a voiceover. There were some pretty cool parts when Tim shot me. I remember one part specifically. If you guys don't know the layout of Hollywood Sports Park, it's pretty even playing field, I would say. There's a lot of really good hiding on both sides, but there's just one part where I peeked out. The sun just kind of hit me in the eyes, no excuses or anything. And I just peeked out, and before I even had a chance to realize where Tim was, I got a shot straight between the eyes. I saw the BB coming and everything. And I was just like, oh man, nice shot, Tim. It was just one of those fun
times. I gotta interject here.
Okay.
Marks, we should not be using his first name. He is still in FNG.
He is the new guy. That's
so he is not.
We won't have a nickname for him yet. We're calling him Q for a minute, but
Q.
His last name ends with Q.
Oh,
his first name
ends with Q.
Well, he doesn't get a cool nickname until he passes his FNG.
I call him Gluteus Maximus Marcus Aurelius.
Just the longest name.
The longest. It's not a nickname. It's a long name.
Yeah.
Oh, it's actually Gluteus Maximus Marcus Aurelius
Decimus. Is he an ass gladiator?
I don't know. Every time I see Gladiator, my name is Maximus Decimus. I'm like, oh, Gluteus Maximus.
And then your FNG status mark is not lifted until somebody says it is lifted.
This is
just
true.
Because there is new FNG, you are no longer. It doesn't
you
mean
said
that
two
you are
FNGs.
No
yeah, we have two FNGs. Yeah.
Yeah,
you got the probation
it's
period.
It's FNG1 and FNG2.
I know when I started, me and Frank were little button heads there now and then, but now we've kind of gone past that.
Well, because that's the FNG.
Gotta have the ground rules.
There's the probation there.
I like the Gluteus Maximus. Gluteus
Maximus
really
is
name.
Yeah, because
oh man, you should have been here. We were playing some football out in the parking lot again.
Were you?
Yeah, we had the warehouse out there and everything.
Oh
fun.
Man.
You don't play no street ball.
AS for life 1-2-3. You better be signing for the Timpire.
Oh man, that game is going to be super exciting.
Tim, do you even lift?
Do you even lift?
No.
He lifts burgers into his mouth.
As often as I can.
Speaking of burgers,
burger.
In-N-Out later on.
In-N-Out later. Yeah, I haven't had In-N-Out in a long time.
Actually, I think it's been like at least a good month or two since I've had In-N-Out too. Bob is like an In-N-Out fiend. Every time I see that guy, he's got In-N-Out.
I feel like
he always comes in with like either In-N-Out.
You better not lose that 200-pound challenge.
Oh no, I'm going to win already. I'm already down 10 pounds this week, man. So Bob's That's going cool. down. But he already got an LM4, so it's like the challenge is kind of weak sauce at the moment. So,
well, there's nothing wrong with him having two or you getting an LM4 also
on
his dime.
No, I'm going to get an SSR if that happens. So
you can't change the rules of the bet.
No,
the bet
was an LM4 or an SSR.
Oh,
so I get an SSR, he gets the LM4. So. Because they're roughly around the same price range. So. Mm-hmm. Because I said LM4 and some accessories because they're not, you know.
Accessories,
as Tim says.
Will the world end?
Don't know.
Could happen, man.
Let's find out.
It
I don't think it will.
Could happen. No one knows. Anything can happen. It's probable.
Well, technically,
I've told you
world,
my theory about that.
Technically, a part of the world is on the 21st.
Hey, the Mayans,
I guess
the Mayans didn't live in Australia,
them.
Bro.
Yeah.
The Mayans did not live
yeah,
in Australia.
That's
bro.
Why. They did live on our
Australia. Our continent.
Yeah,
so
that's true.
We'll see what happens. I personally don't think so, but we won't get into that.
Are people talking about League of Legends?
We'll just find out. We're going to have a live show on Monday, Christmas Eve, the 24th.
We will
Since our normal live show is on Tuesday, but that's Christmas, everyone's going to be with their family.
Yep.
We're doing it Christmas Eve at 2 p.m. our time. So you East Coasters or Ricard, who is normally up at 3 a.m. watching our show, he can now watch it earlier
exactly.
in the day on the 24th.
Yeah, that should be a pretty cool show. I'm excited for that. I may not be here. It depends. I'm hoping to try to get here over time, but I got a ticket for having tent on my car.
That's the lamest ticket ever.
Isn't it? Yeah. That cop must have been really
hard. Why are you
going
to court for the ticket? Isn't it just write it off, like get it removed and write it off?
Jeez, that's
like
what
that?
I thought.
Hey, man. Don't we know the cops on the street?
No, I don't think it was those guys. I didn't get it in the city.
If it's not, yeah.
No, I did get it. Yeah, I got it.
Is it a sheriff?
No, it was a motorcycle cop, so I assume it's City of Walnut. Or maybe it was West Covina.
I don't know if the Walnut Sheriff's had motorcycle. It may have been CHP or West Covina PD.
Josh's gloves are Oakley's on the Oakley website. That is correct. Those are Oakley gloves that I was wearing in my loadout video. Super cool.
I've had Oakley gloves. Times. They're right.
I do like those gloves a lot.
I've had two pairs.
The only thing I wish they had was a little more protection right on these set of knuckles. That's the only thing I wish.
What kind of car does Frank drive?
Mazda Speed 3.
Yeah, Mazda Speed. Good car.
If you're anybody's wondering about any of my gear, go watch the video. It's up now, so it's on the main channel. Why weren't you in the loadout? Let's word on Bob. I wasn't in the loadout because, I don't have a legitimate reason. I think I just didn't want to be on camera.
I was lazy.
Legitimately, yeah. I was just like,
Josh, we got to do your tactical gear.
I was like,
okay, yeah. You ready? No.
Yeah. Hey, you ready to do your tactical gear? Nah.
Okay, well, it's got to get done. Bob, you do it.
There's Bob in the gear. Bob's roughly the same size as me. It would take
minus 10 pounds.
Minus 10 pounds, basically. Yeah. Which adds back onto the camera. So you're good to go. So. Your stock is nice. Thank you. I'll take that as a compliment.
Can you show us that BHDXM177 behind you?
The painted gun?
Yes.
We can show you it. There's not much to... I mean, it's kind of like a...
We were going to do a Black Hawk Down thing a long time ago.
I feel like everybody asked about this gun, though, just because it's painted. Wait till they see the next
painted
gun.
Wait till they see the other painted gun I have, so...
We have something really cool in the works for you guys. We're not talking about it just yet. We're hoping to have it released.
Who was it in Black Hawk Down that used this gun? Was it Chigard or Gordon?
I think it's Gordon.
Chigard was the M14. Anyone know? Chigard was the M14, and Gordon used...
Why?
1733.
Are we going to
sign
into this with that?
No. Eric Banley
used this. Oh my god, look at this! Fucking modified spinny handguard. The spinny handguard mod. That's a pretty legit mod. Well, for when you have a red dot and you want to cant it real quick.
No, what that is, it's the continuously variable handguard alignment.
Okay. Now you got hoverboard.
You gotta have a cool acronym though to
it's
go with.
Hoverboard.
So, yeah.
Oh yeah, check that out.
You gotta have a cool acronym. So does the Chris have the downward recoil system like the real one does?
Yes.
Yes, it does.
Stay tuned to GITV. We're going to do a an internal breakdown.
Oh, we
course.
Are? Oh, yeah. Cool. That should be
soon.
Exciting.
Very soon.
We're going to do some internal breakdown. Actually, we could probably use that little video thing I put together for that.
Oh, yeah.
We could totally do
that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
If I can get a picture of the internals taken like that, then I can...
The Chris is a waste of money. Why would you say something like that?
I would not say
so overpriced.
Hey, why don't you build
define
a Chris and then send me the sheet for it, and I'll buy one from you.
Define what exactly is overpriced?
Overpriced is I'm not working, so I don't have money to buy air.
Oh, so you just can't afford it. That's
right,
what overpriced
right.
is.
Okay. No, Frank did not get his Vector yet.
Not yet. Employees can't even get it yet.
Yeah,
all the pre-orders and
employees got banned from buying it.
Yep, for at least for a little bit. So
I'm quite upset.
I know. I was actually looking forward to seeing some cool mods coming out of that stuff. So, hey Frank, what's your thoughts on the Wii's AEG M4 release this year?
The Wii's?
Frank's not a big fan of WE.
Wii's M4?
Their M4 AEG, we actually have a sample. It's actually not too bad.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that,
was okay.
Was that that one? Oh no, that was Lonex that we had that sample.
It was a Lonex one. Oh yeah, we still gotta show that off too.
Yeah, that Lonex M4?
Those are gonna be kind of like our base for series coming
out. Oh, question mark.
Yeah. Uh-oh. When are you doing another Panini unboxing?
Didn't you just do it like
the high dollar
ago?
Unboxings.
Oh,
somebody
my
actually watches
God,
those.
Somebody actually does watch that. Well, Frank unboxed some product yesterday and got shafted. He's not very happy right now. He doesn't want to hear the word Panini.
Walter was telling us, dude, Frank's getting his... No, it's not good. It's
not
good.
Not good.
Can't say it on camera.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. I was pretty upset.
Yeah,
Walter does that though because he just laughs it off because he doesn't open cards anymore. But
he does. Dude.
Oh,
he got shafted pretty bad last week, so it was kind of funny.
Some of that's the kind of car I drive. I drive an RX-8, also made by Mazda.
Yeah, so. That's right.
Well, hey man, we all waste money on things.
Do we ever plan on going to HSP again? Yes.
HSP is a great playing field. I prefer HSP over Tech City. I said it. I don't know. I just don't have fun at Tech City for some reason. Anytime I go there, like, not that it's a bad place to play. Super fun place to play and film too. I don't know, man. It's not my style of play, I guess.
Everybody's different, man.
I like jumping over cars and shit. So, what can I say?
Jumping over cars?
Yeah. Yeah, the cars. Like,
as long as you're not, like, jetting, you fall through.
That was so
We were filming something at HSP, like, 6 months ago.
Somebody actually remembers your M3 commercial, dude.
Dude, a lot of people have seen that one.
Yeah, that's M3 and the M3.
That's one of our more popular videos. I'm freaking pissed that it didn't win anything for
the plates or whatever.
The
competition for Webbies.
Dude, for reals. The popular airsoft.com Players Choice Awards last year, and I guess nobody nominated that for the best video for airsoft. I mean, I guess it's not really an airsoft video. It kind of is. It's got the Aries M3 in it. Nobody nominated that for the funniest video.
Oh, man, that was such a great.
I thought it was a good video. Maybe I'm partial because I like driving my car. But, yeah, I mean, the third annual Players Choice Awards are actually starting the nominations right now. So you can nominate whoever you want for the category. If you guys go to popularairsoft.com, vote GI.
Oh, yeah. Have some fun with it. So.
Yeah.
But back to the story about Jet. When we were filming that product review video that just got up with recently, Jet, there was a specific scene where Tim jumps over the car and goes through. And Jet was like, you know what, man? This seems kind of a little safe. Let me, like, make sure you're not going to fall through this thing. So I'm going to put a little bit of my weight. Boom! Falls right through the windshield.
You
misstepped
or something.
Jet, what are you doing, man? Like, we just talked about how unsafe this is. And lo and behold, luckily,
he works there.
Yeah,
he should be covering
the event coordinator, so we didn't have to worry about too much about it.
Yeah, for reals. My M3's slow for...
What is everyone with a TM MP7? It's a Tokyo Marui MP7. It's the same thing as a regular MP7. Just made by Tokyo Marui.
88. My M3 is slow.
Yeah.
Do I watch Horsepower Freaks? No. I don't have a lot of horsepower, so I don't watch any of that stuff. Do I watch Burn Notice? No, I don't really think that show's very good. That guy's mouth really bothers me.
I didn't play in India. I'd love to play in India. That'd be awesome.
Indiana.
Oh, India. Oh, well.
Is it?
It's red text, man. I can barely
Indiana.
I can barely read it from here. Red text.
India and Indiana. Oh, they're neighbors.
Hey, India would be super sweet to play in.
What? Well, what was that about?
Hmm? Do you watch
your boxes?
Like, watch. I don't see what you're talking about.
AEG MP7? Are people unaware of the AEG MP7? Frank, did the Gearbox 2.2 VFC have
the
same measurements as a normal version 2 like Polar Star?
So he's asking, can I put a Polar Star in my VFC?
What is a 2.2 VFC?
I have no idea. Is there they're making updates to the Gearbox?
Here.
I bet you somebody's...
Sir Death, I need you to elaborate. What is a 2.2 VFC?
Let's see if he already did or not.
I don't watch The Walking Dead.
I watch The Walking Dead. It's a really good show.
Opinion on Polar Star. Those guys are really cool. They make race cars.
Yep, pretty legit.
And they make fast race cars.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we watch Dexter.
Dexter? Oh, man. Did I call the ending of that season?
SHS? Anything someone made or touched or coming out of SHS, I do not touch.
JB wants to know if... Yes, he can. Mark, tell
Mark
him yes.
Top Gear UK?
Of course.
Yes, every episode on DVD and Blu-ray.
Operation In State. Nope, never heard of that one.
Polestar said they're working on a new fusion engine, but it will be more expensive. The one's already expensive. We don't need a
fusion engine can
one.
Be more expensive.
Do I work on my own internals? No.
No. That's what Frank is for. He's the master.
Yeah. He gives me cigarettes, too.
Exactly. Yeah. That's the way to do it.
Frank takes
I pay Frank
in cartons.
In cigarettes, and then Frank makes my gun shoot very well, and then I get to shoot my boss when we go to Hollywood Sports Park.
Except I shot you in the face.
I totally shot you in the container. I shot you in the
you
container.
You did shoot me.
I shot you in the container.
But I shot you in the face.
You shot me in the face. It was a good shot.
With
I said it was
with
a good
left-handed
shot.
Left-handed shot.
I said it was a good shot.
It was a good
when
shot.
When you hit me, I was like,
I was
damn,
really,
Tim, that was a good shot. You can hear it on the console.
I was really bummed that because I was shooting left-handed. I had to switch because the wall was right there. The camera didn't pick it up.
Kind of cool. The most expensive card we pulled was actually out when we were in Virginia. We pulled a card out of a box. Tim was there.
Mm-hmm.
And we actually got upwards of $3,000 for it.
The Jordan?
$3,000.
Or the John Wall.
The John Wall.
John Wall.
Frank got a John Wall. It was like 1 of 5 or something
like
that?
It was 5 of 5.
Five of five? That's
and we sold it for $3,000.
Uh-oh. Hey, Firefox update.
If you're a fan of whatever sports, you know, kind spend some money. Gotta spend some money to support your stuff, you know?
Frank didn't spend $3,000 on it, though.
No,
yeah. In a box.
Any update on the ERGs?
No. Nope. But you gotta pay to play. That box was $600. So.
Yeah. It's a good return on investment. Good
sometimes,
ROI.
Sometimes you win, or sometimes, like yesterday, you don't win.
Yeah.
So.
I should get a Hennessy Lotus Venom GT.
Oh, Tim is actually, really he's like got a bit of a hard-on for that car.
That's
when we're talking about the modified GTR versus the Hennessy GT.
That wasn't the Hennessy
that's,
one.
That's,
it was some.
No, that's the.
Is that that guy in
that's Palm the Lotus? Deal? That's the Lotus one.
The dual injected one in
yeah,
Palmdale.
That's the Lotus one.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure.
Okay. Yeah, I like that car a lot.
Yeah,
that car's freaking
ridiculous.
Sick.
The one that's like it's like stretched just a little bit, like has a little
wheel,
bit more.
The wheelbase is
yeah.
extended. It's supercharged and turbocharged.
Exactly.
It goes real fast, but it breaks a lot. Obviously.
Yeah.
I think Lotus. Lotus is a British company, right? They don't make cars
yeah.
anymore.
No.
I don't use my Echo and Platinum anymore. I gave it to my uncle.
For any of you guys who want to see Tim doing a cosplay of Psy from Gangnam Style, go watch the recent Chris video. I let Tim borrow my electric Loveless sunglasses, and he put them on, and they're like they look just like the you know the black Warfarers, and I was like,
Gangnam
oh, Tim,
style.
You're Gangnam Styling it over here with the Chris. So yeah, go watch that video. It's super funny.
I didn't even recognize this.
Systema
yeah.
PTW or Celsius.
Do I like the new 4 Series? Not really. The new 4 Series?
Not a big fan of it either.
The new 4 Series BMW? Do you hear about that, Frank? They're taking the Coupe 3 Series, turning it into a 4 Series, and the 3 Series is going to remain a sedan.
Yeah.
Which I think is dumb, because if they make an M, it's going to be an M4.
So the M4...
The M4 is going to be the M3 Coupe.
Oh, so now you can have an M4 in your M4.
I know, right? That would be sick, but I don't think I can afford that car. It's going to be like $80,000.
This guy keeps asking the same questions.
Systema
PTW or Celsius?
You can't beat the original. You got to go with the PTW.
Yeah, we at the time, we only supported Systema PTWs. We didn't support the clones. But we did have a customer that came in with a CTW, and he's all like, oh, it's a piece of junk. How do I make it better? He ended up buying all kinds of Systema parts.
And
so he paid, instead of the $700 for the challenge kit, he ended up paying like $2,000 worth of parts.
Oh, jeez.
Because he replaced everything. He's all, I want to turn the cylinder, then he replaced the hop up, then he replaced all kinds of stuff.
So he ended up buying a PTW and putting it in a Celsius body. M6 Grand Coupe. Yeah, that thing looks okay. I don't know. I don't think about the... The Grand Coupe is the...
M6s.
The Grand Coupe is the four-door 6 Series, right?
I didn't know they made a 4 or 6
series. Yeah, it's called the Grand Coupe.
Oh, there you go. Tim, what's your favorite airsoft pistol ever?
I don't know. I mean, they all really are kind of sick. This is actually my first gas blowback pistol. This is a KSC GTC.
I do love Glocks. That thing's awesome.
I think I'm going to get myself a Glock.
Hey, I thought you liked your high cap.
I like the high cap. Actually, I really...
Strike kit or whatever?
Yeah, I had a high cap with a tactical impact device on it. Very accurate gun right out of the box. The slide, because it was plastic, cycled really quickly. The TM high cap is probably, it's got to be one of my all-time favorites, if it's not the all-time favorite. I actually don't, to be honest with you, I don't like this gun that much. It's, the KSC Glocks, they look cool, oops, but they're not real accurate.
Wow.
Okay. So I saw a question. It's our fearless leader that gets me my Panini cards.
Yes.
Our boss.
I'm becoming Bob. How so?
Because Bob has.
I disagree with
that.
Oh, drop it.
G&G versus
drop
Matrix.
One thing.
Seriously, what kind of question is that?
G&G versus Matrix.
Really?
What's Matrix?
I think it's isn't it E-Bikes clones.
G&G.
I don't know if that's correct.
G&G.
Don't quote me.
Just
yeah.
That.
I don't know. I don't know. I actually don't know who makes those. Oh, okay. Well then, G&G. Yeah. I really like the guys over in G&G. They're awesome. So.
G&G makes cool stuff.
I do.
I don't know about that G26. That one's a little too futuristic for my taste, but they make some awesome stuff. I have two G&G scars, if that says anything.
Yeah. Frank doesn't carry an airsoft pistol. He carries 3 extra mags in its place.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. I don't carry a pistol either. I'll rock that with you. I'm not a, I mean,
TIE Fighter.
If I need to transition.
TIE Fighter. I think that guy's a Star Wars fan.
Or maybe it's Andrew on his alt account.
No, because TY.
Oh. It'd be funny if it was TAI.
He's looking for a sidearm. Yes, the KWA USP is good.
Yeah.
UPS is also a great courier in which you can get your USP. So if you want
to
get
it, send you
a
USP, UPS, overnight.
Insured.
Overnight if you pay for it.
Yeah,
exactly. They do some pretty good stuff.
What can Brown do for you?
What does KWA stand for? I don't know.
Korean Women Association.
There you go. You heard it first.
Mm-hmm.
Korean Women Association.
You should tell KWA to make an HKP 30. They might. You know, you can't really, I mean, I could tell KWA whatever I want. Whether they do it or not is really up to them. But, you know, they have a lot of HK guns, so maybe the P-30's in the lineup. I don't know.
Your answer should have been already did.
Did I? I don't know.
We'll see what happens.
Why don't we have G-17 and G-18s on our site? Because Glock doesn't like people to make airsoft guns that look like their guns. So they said,
no,
don't make them anymore. So nobody can make them anymore.
Yes.
Yeah, KWA doesn't hurry up with anything they do. No. They want to make sure everything is as perfect as it possibly can be before it gets released.
KWA, they take their time. Sometimes, you know, we wish they would come out with stuff faster. But you know what? In the end, the product is good.
Yeah.
Kind of like Blizzard. Their stuff takes forever to come out.
I remember. Don't even get me started.
Well, StarCraft 2 was announced when I was in high school.
10 or 15 years.
Yeah.
10 years for StarCraft 2 to come out. Oh my goodness. But when it came out, it's one of the best games.
Yeah.
It's one of the best StarCraft.
It is
the best real-time strategy game.
It was announced when I was in high school.
Ever.
And it
yeah.
just came out 2 years ago.
It's funny because like StarCraft Brood War came out, and then they were like, Command & Conquer was like 5-1, and then finally StarCraft comes out, and now they're revamping the entire Command & Conquer series.
To compete with StarCraft.
I don't know if they're like gonna try to compete with them because I mean, really,
wait, is
you
Command and
can't
Conquer?
Compete.
That's not a Blizzard game, is it?
No.
I actually don't know who makes that now. I think Activision owns it now.
Mm-hmm.
They may have bought the licensing for that. Yeah, Command and Conquer was really fun. Generals, I had a great time getting down on some Generals. That's a really fun game.
I've never played Command and Conquer.
Dude, Generals is awesome, man. Get the Aurora Bombers.
I used to just get a whole bunch of those nuke fighters.
Yeah, the Aurora Bombers. Yeah,
yeah,
the ones that go so fast that the missile turrets can't hit them. Yeah, it's kind of cheese, but what do you do? Super fun.
Not know anything.
This guy doesn't know what's going on over here.
I played Brood War and I played Warcraft 3.
It was kind of funny with those spiders, dude, because they shoot little nuke missiles.
Yeah.
And then it'll blow up a tank. The tank will fly in the air and all the other missiles will fly at that tank. It'll just blow it off the screen.
That game was so awesome. I really enjoyed it. Such a good time. Command & Conquer series. StarCraft 2 now, pretty much the only thing on the market dominating everything. So.
Which you don't play, according to
Actually, I have a new computer now, so I'm going to start trying to play it a little bit.
Oh, yeah. That super monstrous tower thing.
Well,
I'm a Bob.
What can I say? It is VSC quite.
Scar. I like the VSC Scar. It's a good gun.
I really like the VSC Scar. It's the two-tone.
What ELO are you?
Black.
Electric
ELO.
Light Orchestra?
ELO refers to a ranking system for League of Legends. Last season, I finished my ELO roughly, I think it was like 2020. So a little over 2020, which is, I guess, is pretty good from what I hear.
Do I like the TMPX4?
That's about it, though.
Yes.
The
TMPX4
Burger
is good.
King.
What the? How about neither? How about you go eat some vegetables? You ever seen,
I
you guys know those stuff that was green that you used to eat, like lettuce and spinach?
Boobs are ass.
Boobs are ass. I'm definitely a butt guy for sure.
What kind of question is that? Both.
Both, obviously.
Ooh, Five Guys or In-N-Out?
Oh, that's a tough question. I like the fries from In-N-Out because they can get animal styled.
But the Five Guys
but
fries?
But the base fries, just the fries themselves, I prefer Five Guys fries. But because
but
you can animal style
like,
them.
Modify your fries at Five Guys.
You can modify fries at In-N-Out.
Not in the same way. Yeah, you can get
animal
style. You can get them extra crispy or something like that. But like Five Guys, they have different seasoning you can throw on it. But I like In-N-Out better because I think Five Guys way.
Where's Five Guys?
There's one in Cerritos. Oh, there's one in Fullerton, actually.
Yeah, not too far.
There's one in Fullerton next to Cal State Fullerton.
Weren't there a whole bunch of those in Virginia?
It's an East Coast thing, I think.
Oh.
I think it's an East
Coast
thing.
Why didn't we go to any?
Oh, that's right.
We
have them here.
Trying
in
to find a bowl of pho.
Yeah.
Frank is addicted to pho, like, so much. He probably eats it probably 4 to 5 times a week, if not more.
Yeah. But so. When we went to Virginia, we were looking for pho, and it took a trial and error, and we found, before we found one that was reasonable. We didn't really find a good one that we really liked. Yeah.
Yeah. The I definitely think the burgers are probably a little better from In-N-Out, though.
I don't know, man.
I'm partial.
Burgers are pretty. I don't know.
One of my cousins is one of the managers, so I kind of jacked up if I head down there.
What?
So.
I like In-N-Out a lot. I think In-N-Out is the best value for a good burger for your dollar.
Oh yeah.
Five Guys is kind of expensive. Kind of worth it if you think about the customization you're going to do to your burger. There's only so much you can do to a burger, you know?
Yeah. Well, I don't know, man. I just recently found out about the whole over-easy egg on top of it, which was apparently absolutely delicious.
Over-easy
egg. Oh, I just found out this other place called Slater's 50-50. They
oh,
do 50% or 50% bacon and 50% burger and meld them together.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Oh, so delicious.
I've heard of Slater's. I don't know if I've ever eaten there.
Yeah. So, guys in the chat, let's a little bit less of the Two Girls, One Cup, a little bit more about anything else. So,
oh, I think
yeah.
only one person's mentioned that.
No, it's been mentioned multiple times. So.
Are people still talking about that?
Yeah, it's still on there. So.
Wow.
Yeah. So let's keep the chat a little clear of that. We do have some younger viewers. I don't need anybody accidentally Googling something that could scar them for life. So
yeah, really.
Yeah. Let's go.
Two guns, one lipo.
Two guns, one lipo. How would you do it? Like, split the other end? Like human centipede lipo?
No. The human centipede.
That's a horrible film.
That's a horrible film.
Yeah. I just went from like something worse to worse. So.
Yeah.
You should make a retail store in the Midwest. Man, that would be cool.
That would be cool. Retail stores all over the place. Everybody wants a Nerfsoft GI in their hometown.
I know I do.
There is a Nerfsoft GI in your hometown.
Oh, I live in Walnut. That's right.
Oh, that's right. You live in Walnut.
I do live in Walnut. I guess it's just down the street.
Why do I have the pistol? Why not, drunken dwarf? Why not have a pistol? I work at an airsoft store, man. I've got guns all over the place.
I think I've got two guns on my desk right now, and then...
I have this and our other modified Glock that you and Ross worked on that we haven't implemented.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that one's going to be cool.
That one's going to be gnarly once we do that.
The Kling Canteen thing hasn't been redeemed yet, so I don't know where Andrew hid that.
There's an HK-45 up for grabs, and one of our water bottles still has not been redeemed.
I'm going to start looking for it, so I can find it.
You get rated dumb 24/7? What?
You know what somebody probably did was like, oh, man, I got a bottle.
If somebody accidentally threw it away.
Or they're like, oh, this is instructions. I don't need this.
Yeah, exactly. That'd be so funny. If no one redeems it, I mean, I guess we got to set some kind of time with
another
one,
I guess.
I don't know.
Maybe by the end of 2013 or 14 or something.
So I kind of have an interesting question for two of you guys. Since you guys go really, really way back for the Airsoft thing, like, what do you guys think the future of Airsoft is going to be? Is it going to be like, oh, we're going to come out with the version 4 gearbox and it's going to be so, like, new and legit? Or is it going to be, you know, is Polestar the future? Is, you know, like, where can we go from here?
Polestar really isn't going to be it isn't really the future because not everybody wants to carry an air tank.
Right.
There's going to be, in my opinion, Frank is kind of on the right track. There's a divide. There's going to be an even more of a divide between the airsofters because you've got the ultra realistic hardcore Milsim guys that wear the real plates and all the gear and stuff like that. I think they're going to move towards the type of gas blowback guns like the KW8 and the 4, that type of stuff, because it is as realistic as it can get. And then you have the guys that just want pure performance. They want the high rate of fire. They want the adjustable rate of fire. Don't care as much about realism. They're going to go in the direction of the AEG / Polar Star Fusion engine. I don't think the Fusion engine is going to take over unless there's more competition in the market that can make it cheaper. Because right now...
I've heard Daytona, I think there's another manufacturer that's trying to compete with them a little bit. I don't know too much about them, though. I really...
Maybe. Here's
the thing, though. If you have something out there that's made by a group of guys and they put a lot of time and effort into it, and you just have somebody copy it, it's kind of like...
Kind of sucks, yeah.
That's life, man. Airsoft is not the first industry to have that happen.
But I mean, it's not to say that, someone's going to take it over, is going to make it cheaper or whatever.
Yeah.
That everybody's just going to go, oh, I want one too.
Yeah.
So,
I feel
someone
like
me, Polar Stars are nice. I like our sample that we got. Shot really nice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's awesome. But I don't want it carrying an air tank.
Yeah, exactly.
And have a hose coming out of the bottom of the gun,
Yeah. It is a little cumbersome, I guess, to have that extra equipment there. But I don't know. In my opinion, that's what's going to happen. There's going to be a divide, and even more of a divide, between the real milsim or just real simulation airsofters versus the guys that just want to go out and shoot no matter what.
I definitely agree that I feel like it's progressing that way because, like, more any of the hardcore milsim dudes that I meet, all of them are running, like, LM4s or, some of the SMGs and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I definitely feel like it's progressing more towards the, for Milsim guys at least, more towards the gas blowbacks.
Yeah,
but
they get better in technology.
Yeah, I guess more of my question was, like, do you guys think there's going to be new systems where, like, everything is taken care of inside of the mag, where you basically, your mag is your whole primary firing system where you insert the mag and then...
Well, that's the way the gas blowbacks are.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying, like, but that more so geared towards, like, people who don't want to spend, like, $50 a mag.
The AEG is going to be the affordable platform. I mean, look at Lancer Tactical right now. We have an M4 AEG under $100.
Yeah,
the externals are made of plastic. But the gearbox is solid. It's been proven by us, by other retailers that have done stress tests,
exactly.
By other people who aren't retailers that have, they're not gaining anything by doing reviews, but
they're just
trying to destroy it. The Lancer Tactical is the really affordable gun. Not only that, like, AEGs have gotten a lot cheaper over the years, and they're probably going to continue to drop, so... I mean, you're going to have AEGs probably be your entry point for Airsoft. for the newbie player that just wants to play, because you can get it for really cheap. And then from there, if that player progresses on in their airsoft career, they're going to decide whether they want the ultra realism of Milsim or whether they just want to go out and have a good time and play, like, you know, force on force and stuff like that. So from there, they'll decide whether to go with the AEG platform and keep building on their AEGs to start over with the Fusion engine, or to go Milsim and go full, like, gas blowback and stuff
so,
like
so
that.
So what you're kind of saying is you feel like there's going to be a progression of, like, so, like, say $300 tier guns now are going to drop down and be, like, the $100 guns, and it's just kind
of... Maybe not that cheap necessarily,
but it's going to keep progressing.
It will probably continue to get cheaper as airsoft continues to grow, because... I mean, it's just kind of like the laws of economics and stuff like that.
I definitely think that that makes sense. I mean, I just kind of would like to see, you know, I guess there's not really so much you can do with a gun, especially as far as, you know, gearboxes go and all that kind of stuff, but...
The thing is about it is that there's not much that needs to be done. There's a couple of tweaks here and there that people can do to the AEG gearbox, but, you know, when Marui came out with the gearbox, that was the most efficient way to have an airsoft gun at that time, and it still is a very efficient way.
JD is already better than KWA after tuning.
Yeah, go ahead. Sure. We can go with that. I can make a Civic faster than a Ferrari if I want to. But that doesn't mean I'm going to if I had
yeah.
You know, I could spend $50,000 on a Civic and make it super freaking fast. Or I could just have like a stock Beamer.
Yeah, that's kinda funny. That's the same analogy I gave you, right? You give somebody $1,000 a year building an airsoft gun, oh yeah, I wanna start with a JG.
You can. You can do that if you want. You know, it's America.
How many people would actually do that though?
Yeah.
People that want to save money, but
it's like, hey Josh, here's $100,000. Build whatever car you want. Oh yeah, I'm gonna start with the Honda Civic DX, man. I'm gonna buy all this stuff for it.
Yeah, exactly.
Josh is gonna be like, I'm going straight for the GTR.
Yeah, I'm gonna go straight for the GTR. I don't really need too much.
GTR with some wheels and call it a day.
Exactly. Maybe get a little tune up here, but that's about it. I mean, I kind of agree with you guys. I feel like, you know, people are always making the arguments, oh, you spent all that money on that gun, you could have just got this and then upgraded it. It's like, yeah, but
The funniest one is, oh, I could buy a real blah, 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 blah for that.
Yeah, exactly. That's such a dumb argument. But you could totally upgrade and do this. And it's like, yeah, well, I can buy the KWA and then, like, I don't know,
do anything.
Go down the street, and if it breaks, they'll fix it for me and then send it back to my house, no problem. It's like, it's cool to upgrade your guns. I understand that. My gun is completely upgraded. I'm not going to sit here and say that I'm impartial to that. But
you started with a KWA.
But I started with a KWA. What can I say? I like nice things, right? I mean, mm-hmm. but at the same time, like, yeah, it's kind of to each his own. I feel like if you bought something stock, like, I would totally, if my SR7 stock was a great gun, I loved it. It fired perfectly fine. I only upgraded it because I wanted to see if I could do it.
Because you could.
Because I could, yeah. Because I work at SFG, and I will be damned if I don't have a custom before.
But you didn't upgrade it.
No, I personally didn't upgrade. No. I still know nothing about what's going on in there. So I had somebody else upgrade it, who's very knowledgeable at airsoft parts. So kind of comes down to one of those.
It's kind of an economical argument, because I think that those that don't have the budget to buy a gun outright are always going to argue for upgrading a cheaper gun.
Yeah. And I will never understand the guys who are like, I could buy a real AR for this price. Well, then go buy one.
I mean, airsoft guns and real guns are completely separate.
Yeah.
You know?
If you can do that, then go buy it. Stop posting on my YouTube channel.
Yes, they look similar, but they're completely separate.
Let's talk a little bit about that game that we had yesterday. We didn't really get to elaborate too much about
a little bit of detail. Yeah, so basically we work at an airsoft store. We go play airsoft.
Yeah.
How come I didn't get to go to that?
I don't know, man. This is holiday season. You got guns to work on, right? I know. Well, maybe next time. Gotta send an email.
We're gonna do something like this more often. I'm actually worth talking with Andrew to do more of an employee game, like on Sundays, that more employees can attend. We're not, like, because the problem with doing games on Saturday and during the week and stuff like that is no matter what, the sales floor guys cannot go.
Yeah, exactly.
Because they have to be on the sales floor. So Sundays are the best days to have employee games because everybody can be there.
Right. But the game was at Hollywood Sports Park.
Your mom goes to college. The Lakers.
Lakers or the Heat? Dang.
Is that even a question?
Yeah, I don't think that's a question at this point.
That was more of a statement, right?
Yeah, the Lakers.
Yeah, exactly. That's why he posted it first. Mm-hmm. So, we basically went to Hollywood Sports Park, and Tim and Bob recently just acquired some brand new LM4 PTRs, if I recall correctly. And we decided to do a little bit of a gas blowback versus AEG to see how it would go down. You guys did have a little bit of the numbers on your side as far as the first two games.
Okay, let's talk about the math.
Let's do the logistics.
Have 40 rounds per magazine. There's only four of us.
Yeah.
We can only pretty much shoot semi-auto. Your gun shoots probably 20-something. BBs per second. Mark's gun shoots in the 30s. He loaned another one of his guns to HK, Andrew, who
shoots
in the 30s of the BBs per second.
Maybe
so,
higher.
I mean, you guys may not have had the numbers, but you definitely had those.
We had the firepower. I'll give you that. I agree with you on that one. But you guys also did have some very experienced players on your team. I mean, as much as I don't get to play as much as you guys have played, so I'm still working on it, getting better as we go. Andrew doesn't really play Airsoft all that much. I mean,
not anymore. He used to play a lot.
Yeah, he used to play a lot. Not anymore. And then Mark, who is a frequent Airsofter, so we had him on our team. He was doing some work on you guys. So
Mark is pretty good. He's got the muscle memory down for the M4.
Yeah, for sure. He's really good with that thing. But it was kind of funny because the first game, I think you guys had only two respawns left, right? Well, let me set the parameters for the game. Basically, it was a force-on-force, gas blowbacks versus AEGs. On my team, we had me, Andrew, and Mark. On Tim's team, you had you,
Greg. It was me, Bob, Greg Wong, our friend from NorCal, or a friend from all over.
Yeah, Spartan 117GW, you guys know him.
And we also had Jethro del Castillo. Estillo. So, it was gas blowbacks versus AEGs. We pretty much had all LM4s on our team. And
yeah, pretty much.
You guys had a mixture of M4 AEGs.
Yeah, we did have, all of them were
M4s. Did we win both games? Because we played two games.
Oh, you guys did win both games, yeah. Mm. You guys won both rounds, but I think it was actually a pretty close game. I mean, surprisingly.
I think I got out both times before the end of the game, so I didn't survive till the end.
Yeah.
But,
Andrew, don't forget that you have a kick button, and feel free to use it. I mean, you guys don't have to be nice if people are being jerks, so
I'm just really going to say it right now.
Tim's hungry.
That's the problem with pho, is that I don't...
Do you guys have pho for lunch?
Yeah, but I order the regular bowl of pho, because... Hold on, the large bowl, I can't fit a large bowl in my stomach, right? It's just too much food all at one time.
If
I get the little bowl, I get hungry later.
Here, and that's Tim's words. In layman's terms... Tim eats a little girl's bowl, so after a few hours he gets hungry like a little girl.
Yeah,
exactly.
I've been to Buffalo Wild Wings. Yes, I have. There's a Buffalo Wild Wings that opened up in Chino Hills like a couple years ago, and I frequented that place for years.
Pho is spelled P-H-O, not F-U-H.
Pho.
Everyone's so confused. Like, what is F-U-H?
Where's Tasty Pho? There's a guy.
I know. There's a guy whose name is Tasty Pho
or something like that. He's not here. My favorite wings flavor is the one right above Blazin'. It's like Wild Wings or something like that. Buffalo Wild Wings.
Dude, the garlic are so good.
The garlic is good. They have a lot of good flavors there.
Yeah, for sure. KC is better than KWA because of trades.
That's your opinion. I need a gun for CQB for 350.
Back to the game.
Oh. I feel like we should just wait until the gameplay footage gets
released. Yeah, we shot at each other.
Talking about the game is only fun after the game takes place, and then you can be like, oh, you shot me in the face. Like, oh, you shot me in the leg. Oh, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
That was really close.
I think it lit up a few.
Yeah.
Good times. Pump action sniper.
The fuck? That's what he said.
I know, I saw it.
Pump action sniper, the fuck?
Let's ask some of these questions. What's going on here? Tim shot Andrew in the junk. He did.
Andrew's getting a little X-ray.
And the best part about it wasn't even a regular playing session. We were filming something, so he wasn't even supposed to shoot him, but yet, right in the tip. So.
Bob gets hit in the junk frequently.
I know. Danger is about him.
Bad
Luck Bob is trending on Twitter. Please hashtag that. What was it? Yesterday we were in the warehouse? Thursday. Last Thursday, right?
No, it was Wednesday. Wednesday we were in the warehouse.
Yeah.
Josh, Bob, and I were walking around looking for stuff. And there's like a pile of cardboard boxes that are flattened because, you know, we're putting a lot of inventory away because we're selling a lot of stuff right now. This pile of boxes is probably like 6 feet tall. About as tall as Bob is.
Really huge.
As we walk by, nobody touched anything.
Nobody touched anything.
Josh and I were walking, we were talking, and then Bob was right behind us. And then as Bob walks by, the boxes go...
just
like wave right under.
We look back and Bob's just like, I didn't touch it, I swear! It's like, oh my gosh.
Danger is about him.
Danger is about Bob. Such a true story.
If Bob was like a half second slower, the boxes would just slid and hit him right.
I feel like at any moment, Bob could just like, there's like literally a car accident happening behind him everywhere he goes. Like if you just stop for two seconds, it would just hit him. Yeah, he's like walking through this minefield basically. So it's just super funny. So.
Bob's mom has said to him, was like, Bob, I worry about you. You could die at any moment.
just please stay alive. She's like, I think I remember I was talking to Bob's mom a couple of times when we went up there, and she was like, yeah, I wanted Marie to go to college and do very well, and I just wanted Bob to stay alive. just stay alive, Bob. That's all I need you to do.
He's doing pretty good so far. Almost 30 years without any deaths. A couple of scares, but nothing crazy, scares, obviously.
Yeah. What do you think of SEMA?
I think they're good budget guns.
Yeah, they are. They're good entry-level stuff.
See, the thing is, like, people rip on us sometimes for saying, like, oh, this gun's good, but it's really not good. You really have to understand where we're coming from, because a SEMA gun is really good compared to what SEMA used to be, like, a long time ago. And this kind of really goes back, you know, Frank and I were kind of dating ourselves back here, but not dating each other, but, like, dating as in time. you know? Aging ourselves, man. But...
Good times.
Those guns were terrible back in the day, and they cost just as much, if not more expensive. So, you know, the SEMA guns, the D-Boys guns, all those things have gotten a lot better, and they've gotten cheaper. So, you know, when we say that SEMA's not that bad or D-Boys not that bad, we really mean it. It's not that bad.
For the money.
For the money. Yeah, you like know, you're SEMA only AK, spending.
The SEMA AK is great.
CMO 28, one of the best-selling AKs we've ever had on our website. $109, I think it
is. Dude, such a legit gun for the price.
Extremely cheap, and it's a solid gun for $100. Exactly. I mean, come on, look at how much you're spending, though. That same gun would be really effing terrible like 3 years ago, and would have cost you like $115, $120.
So, SEMA's come a long way. So.
They've come a long way, and they're doing a little better.
Yeah.
And so that's all there needs to be said. So, I mean, it's not that we're trying to, like, pull the wool over your eyes.
They just don't break down a lot, dude.
They don't.
Frank works in the tech department. So, I mean,
something dumb.
Yeah, the tech department handles the RMAs. So
I'd say like at least 60 or 70% of our airsoft guns are broken. They come back because someone did something.
User error.
Yeah, user error.
Most of the time, it's because people don't use good BBs.
And it's usually, another 80% of that is because of the BBs.
The BBs they use are terrible, or people have some misconception that you can drop them and then pick them back up and then use them again.
Right.
That type of stuff breaks guns, and those are the guns that come back in RMA more often than anything else.
And please, guys, clean your guns. Take the time. Just clean it. Just put a little thing in the barrel, clean it.
Were you around, Tim, where the guy was complaining to us that he tried to use his buttstock to breach a door and it broke?
Probably. We've heard all of the stories. Whenever the RMA department gets some crazy explanation, like, oh my God. Yes.
Well, you used to work customer service, right? Yeah, so it was just like, I turned the corner and I ran into a tree. Is there a warranty on the gun?
There's no warranty for gross negligence.
Yeah, exactly.
It's manufactured defect only.
I know.
Oh, man, that always reminds me of that scene in Lethal Weapon 4 where Joe Pesci's, like, talking to Mel Gibson. He's like, hey, you owe me $200-something. He's like, why? Because bullets aren't covered as a natural road hazard. Because he shot his tires out, because he didn't want him to go to the scene. Oh, man. It'd be super freaking hilarious.
That is a great movie.
Will I be revisiting the Midwest? Yes. Sometime in the future. Don't know when. I don't know about that rainbow. That rainbow business.
A little difficult.
It's hard to read. We're just going to skip that. East Coast. Yes, we're coming to the East Coast. In fact, Bob vs. Tim 4, or Tim vs. Bob 4. I always get that mixed up.
TVB, right?
TVB 4 is happening in Virginia.
Yeah.
At Ballhack Airsoft in Chesapeake.
I hope I get to go. If not, I'm seriously debating about buying a plane ticket. So
we'll see what's going on with that, because there may be other events taking place there around the same time. So we'll see how that works out.
I know.
Yeah.
It's going to be an interesting time of the year.
Okay, I got to get back.
All right, Frank.
Cool.
Yeah. See you.
Good to see you, man. See.
Frank is signing out.
Later, everybody.
Peace.
Take off.
Oh, shoot. Look at the time. We've only got a few minutes left.
I know.
Well, 13 minutes to be specific.
So I have a question for you guys. Do you guys want to see us do more of these per week? I mean, because we basically do one on Tuesday, but it's really structured. I mean, we got, you know, the guns, the people, the guests.
It's really structured.
I mean, it's pretty structured. We have stuff that we do want to talk about, you know what I mean? And, there's kind of a response right there. So, I mean, we have 122 beers right now.
This is probably not an accurate sample size. I mean, if I'm being, you know, technical with my statistics, because I think everybody is going to agree that they want us to do this more often.
Yeah, no, I know, I understand that. But I mean,
Every day!
We can't do it every day. I actually have a personal life somewhat, very little of it.
Well, you're here at work every day.
I know, so.
Maybe what we can do is just stream stuff that goes on. Maybe it's just not a live show, we'll just stream.
Like us in the studio filming and hanging out?
I guess, I don't know. Would that be cool?
Well, I mean, if they tune in and like it's just dead, we forgot to turn off the stream or something.
No, that's the point. Like sometimes it'll be dead, and then we'll be there. And
what is we're gonna turn Airsoft GI into a freaking Big Brother?
I guess so.
No, it's too much stuff going on behind the scenes that we can't talk about.
Make more loadout videos.
Did you guys like my loadout video, by the way?
Yeah, it would have been cooler if you were in your gear.
Hey, that happens. Speaking of Josh being on Reddit, I was just on there posting on the Airsoft Reddit about a recent thing that kind of upset me a little bit. So,
is Josh married? No.
Nope, not married.
Do a Q&A, more casual thing. Just keep it structured one on Tuesday. That's a possibility.
I think that's probably a good idea, because this is fun. I like chatting with you guys, talking about...
More tactical gearheads. We're working on it.
Yeah.
We need more tactical gear to do, is the thing. Because the point of tactical gearheads is really to show the gear that we've used.
Right. The purpose behind it.
The purpose behind it. So sometimes we have to do tactical gear that we haven't necessarily used on the field, but, you know, we have enough experience that we can relate to certain types of tactical gear.
I think what we need to do is kind of, like, start grabbing dudes from the sales floor to come in and kind of do some more tactical gear.
You
can
start grabbing dudes. I don't like to
do that.
I'm not aggressive like that.
You got to just get in and do it sometimes, man.
Mm-hmm.
It happens, so.
That's gross.
You know?
Cool sleeves and no gay stuff.
What? I can't guarantee you.
Cool slebs?
I don't know what slebs is.
Okay, Sofa, awesome, needs a gun for under $350 for CQB. He's been asking this question.
It cannot be made from G&G. I don't know what your affinity for non-G&G guns is, but they're really good. I don't know.
Just go with any of the other major brands. KWA,
$350 for CQB.
You're
going to
get a good gun for...
$350, you can do a lot of stuff for $350.
Yeah. Let me just look up.
Can you just drag that to the window so I can see through the chat? Okay, never mind. Yeah, just drag that and then hold it against the... No, hold it against the wall. Let go. Now drag it and hold it against the wall with the top.
Teaching me how to use
hold windows. No, go back. Go back. No, go back. Go back over there. Screw. Gosh.
All right.
This guy doesn't know how to use Windows computers. Anyways, for $350, you got to scroll down the chat so it keeps going. You pause it right there.
Oh man,
it's killing me, Smalls. Anyways, hang on a second here. $350.
Does it have to be an M4?
Yeah, well, he probably wants an M4, because, I mean, let's be honest here, you're not going to get it.
Dude, there is a VFC SR-16 in Santa Sackbuster right now.
That you can get for...
$341.
That's exactly what you need. Go to the Santa Sackbuster section right now, click on Knight's Armament Full Metal SR-16 CQB, remember you said CQB, carbine, and buy it for $341. We'll even
this gun normally sells for $420, is for sale for $341.
What?
You don't see the Sackbusters? It's on the left. Wholesale price deals.
Wholesale price deals on the
left.
That's
where the Sackbusters are. Or you could just search Sackbuster. Can you search Sackbuster?
Well, I don't think so. I should. Yeah, there you
go. Yeah, Sackbuster. Search Sackbuster.
Yeah, Sackbuster.
Dude, we have a VFC PDW. It doesn't get more CQB than that.
Wow, yeah. Seriously.
For $330.
Sofa, you're killing me, Smalls. You're not even trying, man.
You're totally killing.
You're not even trying.
There's two PDWs in there, a 10-inch and an 8-inch.
This is unreal.
Search Santa's Sackbuster.
Santa's Sack was so big this year, it busted, so...
Here, just copy and paste this. Sackbuster.
Sack with a K. There you go.
I think even if you misspell it, it'll still come up.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I don't understand, man. People are always asking these kind of questions, and all you gotta do is take, like, I don't know, 4 minutes, go on the website, browse around, you'll find what you're looking for.
The Sackbuster.
Especially this time of year. I mean, the deals that we have going on are just
ridiculous. I know, it's all Christmas time.
So many good deals.
Speaking of Christmas time.
Head to the walk-in store this Saturday.
Walk-in store this Saturday. It's your last chance to get Christmas gifts.
Yep.
Before Christmas, probably, because we can't.
20% off.
20% off everything in the store. Yeah, I mean, even if you order right now, we can't
ship
it.
So far, are you complaining about iron sights right now? I'm
I'm going to kick you out of here.
Yeah, if you're complaining about iron sights on a gun, guess what? You can change them!
On a gun that's $80 cheaper than it would normally be?
You're ridiculous, man. Ridiculous.
You need to change your name because you are not awesome. You're complaining about iron sights.
Exactly. Unreasonable is what you
need to be. The Sofa Lame.
I'm Sofa Unreasonable.
I'm Sofa Unreasonable.
Two Chainz! Yeah, I listen to Two Chainz on my
car. Hey, what about the Chris? Okay, people are asking about the Chris.
Yeah,
we
Chris.
Showed the Chris numerous times in previous shows, but I think what Josh was referring to when he posted that thing on Facebook earlier today is discussing the gameplay of the Chris, because our friend Greg Wong brought the Chris out to HSP. Because
he purchased one from the walk-in store.
He did purchase one, and after discussing it with him, I think he enjoys it rather well.
Greg said that, like, it's really ergonomical. He liked using it.
Ergonomical. I like that word.
He's had it ergonomical, man. It's not I took some cool pictures for his Facebook. He really enjoyed it. Unfortunately, the only thing is you can only get one mag right now. So
we no, we have mags.
Oh, we have mags?
Yeah, dude. We have mags for sale. They're on the front page of our website. Can be a Chris Max, $44.95.
Well, he only had one mag with him, so let me rephrase that. He only had one mag with him, so he didn't get a chance to
reload.
Yeah, reload. So he was being very conservative.
The Chris is a really cool gun.
Yeah.
It's very ergonomical. Ergonomic. it doesn't have ambi features on it, so it's kind of made for right-handed shooters. But
you can switch the charge handle, I thought, no?
No, there's no way.
Oh, is it because it reveals the bullet right there, right?
The bolt is on the right. The shell ejector port is on the rear end side. But actually, it does have an extra feature. The safety's ambi. I think the fire selector is ambi. So the things that are important are ambi.
Yeah, just not the charging ammo.
But yeah, it's a cool gun. It's a new thing. It's been in lots of video games, which is why it's really popular.
Yep.
It takes a long time for KWA to conceptualize a gun and build it. In fact, I was talking with their product manager, this was a long conversation that we had years ago, but he told me that it takes a year, in Chris's case, longer than a year, and at least, meaning a minimum of $1 million to R&D, build, and test, and create an airsoft gun. So for the Chris, I'm sure it obviously took a lot longer, I'm sure it was a lot more expensive, but, you know, it's a really cool gun, and there's a lot of R&Ding that went into it, and it's really unique, too. There's only one out there, the KWA Chris, unlike the M4, which everybody and their mother makes. So
this is true.
That's all we have to say about the Chris for now.
Indeed. Chris, cool gun.
We should arm wrestle. You want to arm wrestle?
I watched a video recently of someone breaking their arm doing that, and I was like...
So what you're saying is you're scared. I'm too strong for you.
What I'm saying is...
You're saying that everyone overlooks some cheaper guns because they look unappealing. Yeah, they look unappealing, and people judge a book by its cover. So they look overlooked them.
For instance, that Tavor, people will look at that and go, oh, that is an amazingly cool gun. It's completely soft. Like, it's a stock gun. I don't know.
Maybe that's the other thing. That they're just...
Oh, what are you talking?
He's talking about overlooking guns because they look unappealing.
Oh! Oh, my apologies. Yeah, I totally misheard what you said. Yeah.
Because they look unappealing, people overlook them. It's pretty
exactly.
simple, really. Do I know anything about the when the AK-74U GBB will be out? Yes, it will be out in the future. Will come out.
Yeah.
It'll come out in the future.
My name comes out.
Can't change names on here. I don't know.
Someone was asking earlier about my personal YouTube channel and when I'm going to do stuff like that. I might make a post on Facebook about it. I might not.
You have a personal YouTube channel?
Yeah, I'm thinking about doing some cool stuff with maybe Bob, doing some live streams, maybe do some YouTube gameplays and stuff like that. Just us, Bob, hanging out, having fun. Maybe you can jump in on it. We'll do some GTR races and stuff. It could be cool.
We still have to do that in Nuremberg.
Yeah, exactly. Dude, why do you want to do the Nuremberg? It's like an 8-minute lap track. If you DNF, you have to the whole thing over again. Like,
because you chose a track that was beneficial for you, you choose one that's beneficial for me. And
you're just counting.
If you can't get a lap done in 10 without DNFing, then you just shouldn't be driving. That's the bottom line. You just have to slow down and get through the track. What are your thoughts on the KGW Tactical .22? I like that gun. It's neat.
What's that one?
It's the airsoft version of a Ruger 10/22.
Oh, okay. So. Yeah. Actually, we did a review of that. I sound like we dined up, didn't we?
We've done a couple of reviews on it.
I think it's a cool gun.
It's a cool gun.
I like the real-life version of it. It's pretty cool for, like, competition shooting. Like, just fun.
The Ruger 10/22 is a popular gun to modify for competition shooting. Like 22s in general are really popular just for plinking around because $30 gets you, like, 500-plus rounds
if not more.
Of 22 LR.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just cheap, man. You know? It's disposable. I mean, my 22 was only like $180 or something like that.
Exactly.
It's a bolt action rifle.
Exactly.
And it's just fun to just plink around.
22s are really cool. The
22, it's fun to go shooting with people that are shooting shotguns because you take their shotgun shells
and
you
shoot
targets.
Them.
Yeah,
yeah,
you don't
exactly.
even need to bring targets out there.
I do like shooting shotguns. That's really, really fun.
Shotguns are a lot of fun.
Magpul PDR. Oh, I actually saw some recent news about this. Still don't know when it's coming out, but it looks like it's getting production phase maybe or something like that. So hopefully we'll see something soon.
PDR.
I don't know, man. It looks like a really cool gun, man. It's neat looking. So it might be interesting.
KWA ERG.
ERG.
Well, I think the KWA, don't quote me on this, but I mean, they were working hard day and night to get the Chris to us before Christmas, and so they're probably going to shift gears and focus on other things. Maybe the ERG, maybe the AK, maybe all of the other awesome stuff that they plan on making. So we'll just have to wait and see what KWA does.
Yeah. What's your favorite G4 line that we have? G4 guns.
The G4s are all very similar guns.
I still like that Rec 7 kit though. I love the that barrel.
The Rec 7 thing looks cool.
I like that.
I'm kind of partial to the G4 A1. I think it's the mid-length rail.
Yeah.
14-inch barrel, mid-length rail. Mm-hmm. I kind of like that one.
I like the Rec 7. I think it's cool looking. If I had to go with something else, I would probably say I had some new ones in here earlier that had like a, I don't know if it was a TRX rail, somewhere to my rail. I can't remember.
There's a G4 for basically everything that you could want.
Yeah,
there's so many different G4s.
The G4s, that's another thing too. People are always overlooking the G4s, man. G4s are pretty.
I don't think people overlook them, man. We've sold a lot
of
G4s.
Well, no, like as far as when they're like, oh, I need this kind of gun at this budget, this price range.
Oh, yeah.
The G4s are.
The G4s are what you want to look for.
Very good considerable option. Plus, it already comes with a rail, so if you're planning on buying a rail.
It's just a regular rail, though. It's a cool rail. They're usually like Mad Bull, officially licensed, Daniel Defense,
exactly.
TRX, Viking Tactical rails. Like, those are cool rails. They're not just your run-of-the-mill two-piece
M4 that.
Rail.
Yeah, I think people are like, oh, I'm going to buy this gun and then upgrade it. You're going to spend so much more money. Just get a G4 that already has the rail you're looking for, and then you're already halfway done.
You can accessorize it from there.
Yeah, you're halfway done. So,
boom.
Or whatever you need to do, you know?
Boom. Oh, the G418. That's a good one.
The Daniel Defense top model one?
Mm-hmm.
Is that
that's the one.
Yeah, I think I know a shotgun.
I like the G418.
GMP shotguns. Bob really wants to get those in. I know he's working on getting
some of
those.
I've only shot one once. They're pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan of shotguns.
They're fun.
My favorite AK variant? I don't know. I have my Tokyo Marui AK Beta. It's alright.
I really like the standard AK. I've always loved standard AK in video games. I'm playing Far Cry 3 at the moment, which I'm going to be definitely streaming some of that. And the AK in that game is just really a lot of fun. So it's a cool, cool gun. I've always liked the AKs.
I think the AK, it feels just really natural. Because my Beta has a, it's a small gun, but it has a full stock.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of like the Chris in the sense that it's ergonomic and you can bring the sights right up to your eyes very easily.
Right.
I
love the iron sights for AKs too. The iron sights are just so beautiful. I love those things.
It's easy to, they're easy to use, that's for one.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I don't know, the AK, the fact that, just the ergonomics of the charting handle, the fire selector and
so
all that stuff.
SR16, good choice.
Did you buy it?
Good choice. Put that in your shopping cart and take that home because
go buy it, because those are limited quantities.
Yeah, you are not going to have a hard time with that gun. So definitely send me some pictures of you using it too, so I can post that up on Facebook. Be like, happy customer from the live stream. Boom, answer this question. Right.
Put a ridiculous request in the order comments, and we might do something ridiculous.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Did we already talk about the gingerbread man? Yeah, we did.
Yeah, we did.
Mentioned
the gingerbread man.
Other gumdrop buttons!
Yes. Can we sign your box? We most certainly will if you request it.
Yeah. So, Lily, the CFO, brought some cake in. I guess maybe someone's birthday.
Sure, if you eat it. It's Frieza's last day, dude.
Oh, Frieza's last day, right.
Duh.
So we're going to go head out, guys. It's been a great time hanging out with you. I hope we got to answer some questions, do some Q&A for a little bit. We answered a ton of questions. Sorry if we couldn't get to all you guys. There's too many of you.
Daraku Tenshi. Save that question for Bob, because he uses ordnance a lot more than we do. We just shoot people.
Yeah.
Which is, I think, a lot more fun.
Exactly. So, all right, guys.
All right,
we're
going to
head out.
Up.
This will be on YouTube. Catch you guys there. Have fun in the comments, and see you guys later.